So far I've made the wheels and the frame for this bandsaw, and now I need to mount the axles on it so that the wheels can actually turn. And I'll start by making the top wheel mount, and that's got this frame here that gets pulled up by the tension crank for adjusting blade tension, and it's got this knob here that pushes this big hardwood block back to tilt it back, and that tilts the top wheel for adjusting blade tracking. I just cut the pieces for this frame, which really wasn't that exciting, except the wood had a lot of tension in it, and the pinch down on the blade installed the saw. Next, I need to cut some rabbets right here for those to fit together like so. While the glue dries on that, I'll make the bracket that holds this axle. And previously I made this out of a block of hardwood, but this time it'll be sort of a plywood box. And all the pieces on here are roughly rectangular except for this piece, so I printed a one-to-one template. And also a couple of angled holes for attaching it. That shallow rabbet wasn't really necessary, but this piece has got varnish on it, and that's the best way to get rid of it. All the blade tension is going to be pulling down on this block, so I want to reinforce the corners by putting a spline in here. So I've rigged it up with this block to hold it at 45 degrees. And then this block to give me the lateral position. I should have cut these spline slots with a slightly thicker saw blade. I cut rabbets on the edges of the frame to allow it to slide in the slot in the top of the bandsaw. This is going to be the tracking adjustment knob, and I'll put a template for that in the plans once I get around to drawing room. Just a few reinforcing screws because that joint will be under a fair amount of stress. Those screw holes are just a little bit oversized so that plywood can tilt a little bit for tracking adjustment. I'm gluing a strip of hardwood onto the soft wood here so that the top wheel mount frame can slide against it more easily. So the reason I haven't attached this part to here yet is because that way I can still make some lateral adjustments to get this wheel coplanar with the frame. With this one mostly done, I want to put the one on the bottom, and I realized in the design I actually have this one layer extra, so I'll add that now. Now for that bottom wheel mount, on my second and third bandsaw, I used a big block of hardwood with a hole through it to hold the axle. Then on bandsaw number four, I have a block near the bottom wheel, and then another block to hold on the back, and that makes the alignment much easier. But on bandsaw number five, the lower axle actually needs to be quite a bit below the frame, just because the wheels are so big. The mount needs to go right here, but this needs a little bit of flattening first. I only partially threaded those holes so that the bolts really get stuck in there. Whoops. So this complicated contraption will allow me to tweak the alignment of the lower axle even once the bandsaw is done. I'm aligning that axle to be square to the frame, and then I use the position of that axle to figure out where I should put the back support for it. It's always kind of exciting getting that blade tracking on a bandsaw for the first time. And just trying it out by hand cranking it, bandsaws really don't need that much power. So this new one is quite a bit bigger than my 16-inch bandsaw, which in turn is a bit bigger than a 14-incher. And it's got no hope of fitting through this door, although for a standard 7-foot door, it's got a fair bit of margin.